I was born in Brooklyn. I can't say that I was raised in Brooklyn, but I was raised in Chula Vista, which is a small town in San Diego. I have two sisters, and both my parents were all basically musicians. I grew up with a huge musical background. My dad is a bassist and my mom is a choir director. We all sing and play some kind of instrument. That's really kind of how I started the whole audio world, not knowing I was gonna be in audio. I also am a huge video gamer. I love to play video games. Kind of combines everything I love, music, sound, and visuals into one thing. The biggest lesson I learned at Laughs was to always keep learning and growing. The biggest thing after that was constantly being able to change and adapt. They threw in so many classes that if I didn't know how to schedule myself or put anything on a calendar, I would be a complete mess. They taught me how to stay organized and stay teachable. My mentor is Carol Urban. She is a re-recording mixer who we met by happenstance on a women's panel years ago while I was at the LA Film School. She was one of the first people to give me the dirty grunge work. People would say no to this work and I'd be like, yes, 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 give me the grunge work. I need to get dirty and learn how to do this. My proudest moment in my career to this day was mustering up the courage to leave a very comfortable trailer job working at Source Sound for a completely different career path, and that is being a full-time dialogue editor for animation. This was probably the scariest thing I did because I was leaving a job that paid well and it paid weekly on time for something completely new, exciting, but also I wasn't sure it was gonna get picked up again, because if that show ended, that means the job ended. And I am very proud of myself for getting through that decision. Without that decision, I wouldn't have landed all of the dialogue editing jobs I've had to this day. I would have been back still with trailers, which, don't get me wrong, I loved that job. It was a good job, but I felt like I needed to keep moving in a different direction, and switching gears in the middle of that was something I never thought I could do. And I'm very proud and happy that I did it. I love working in the entertainment industry. My favorite thing about it is you just never know what the next project is going to be. It is constantly changing, and that makes it super interesting. I've had jobs where it's so repetitive, it becomes mindless. But working in the entertainment industry, it's all about storytelling, it's about people, it's about bringing people together sometimes, or apart, depending on the story. But it's one of my favorite things. It's constantly changing. Something I live and breathe by this saying. It's gotten me through some of the darkest parts of my life. It's a very simple saying: follow your feet. Literally, your feet will take you wherever they're supposed to take you. You just got to keep following them, one foot in front of the other. This has helped me not only through relationships, it's helped me through career, it's helped me through school, through jobs. I just had to keep chugging along. So follow your feet. That is one of the best pieces of advice and one of the best things to say when you're feeling like you can't do something. Just follow your feet. They'll take you there.